It's working. Yes, it is. Hello, everybody. Happy New Year. It's a new era of gaming. Today, you see me doing something you don't see me do often, which is having Windows open. I know, it's uncommon. Gonna play. This game is called Titanic Adventure at a Time. Hey. Up a take. Don't forget to subscribe. You guys have a... Is an idea? Interesting. Okay. Huh. Interesting. Fixed it. The stupid button on my... Don't forget to subscribe. Let's see how this goes. I know this game because I played it in... Texas. Came out as a demo. And yeah, I'm playing this game. Also buy it on GOG. If you like. Game. Point and click adventure game. Click. Point.
Once again, today's top stories. London has endured another night of German bombing. Most damage was concentrated in the East End. The RAF has struck enemy aerodromes in Le Havre and the Low Countries. In Russia, further German losses are reported around Leningrad. In Asia, the American fortress at Corregidor is still defiant, but Japanese forces are reported nearing the Burmese oil fields. And that concludes the news summary. We now return you to our music program.
Okay. Have this. Got fired? Correct ticket? Parts?
Most damage was concentrated in the East End. The RAF has struck
And I changed it. Oh, that's the great thing about this game. You can. Because he...
See here. This isn't about your dedication. Pringle certainly attests to your loyalty. No, your dismissal stems from the Titanic mission. That failure can no longer be ignored. Especially now. I am sorry. But someone must shoulder the blame. The service, you understand. We can't be held responsible.
Okay. Back there? There's gotta be an air raid. Oh no, hide yourself, children. Hide yourself. Doesn't matter what I do. Here we go. Epic intro. You now. Oh yeah.
The past, forever locked in regret. But what if the past could be changed? Thirty years have come and gone since the night that saw the end of the world, my world. The service needed someone on the Titanic. They chose me. I was to wait for a signal from my contact, so I remained in my cabin. I left only once. Georgia was on board. And that's when it came. There'd be no second chance. It was Sunday, April 14th. Too late, you see, for the Titanic, for me. What if I'd met with my contact, prevented disaster? What if the past could be changed? What then?
Questions. On board the Titanic. We can basically do the same. Somebody's knocking on my door.
Good evening. I am Smethels, your steward. And if I may say so, it is good to see you up and about. You've been in your cabin the whole voyage. A touch of the mal de mer, was it? Seasickness can be quite unpleasant, especially if it's one's first crossing. Since you haven't been out of your cabin, may I instruct you on how to get assistance while on board the Titanic? Very well. Your correspondents. 2,200 on board, and they all want messages delivered promptly. Even if it is 1912, and the Titanic, the most advanced means of sea conveyance ever devised, I still have only two. Here, a map of the ship for you. Compliments of the White Star Line. I have taken the liberty of indicating your cabin, C-73. Of course, on a Sunday evening at this hour, there won't be many people out. Will there be anything else? Have you unpacked? You'll find your trunk key in your bag, on the bed. If you require additional assistance, please ring the bell by the door. Good night.
New music. Cannot open it. That's my girlfriend. And food. Very nice. Okay. I believe I have a key. Yes. Pretty sure the key. Okay, so let's walk the ship, shall we? Need to go to the electric camel. Honor and glory, people. How beautiful. Like this view always. Beauty. Beauty. To the boat deck. It's cold out. Let's keep moving. Need to go to the stairs. Yes. There you go. Rock on.
It's about time. You're late. Another 5 minutes and I'd have cancelled your mission.
Titles on. And before the game crashes, I will say this is when you can. January 22. There we go. Let's talk to her. She'll say the same thing.
It's about time. You're late. Another 5 minutes and I'd have cancelled your mission. Yes, I'm Pringle. Penny Pringle. From the Bureau of Secrets. You didn't think they'd plunk you down on this bucket of bolts and millionaires alone, did you?
Need to fix the audio problem. Second, how to do that.
What a botch up. Some idiot in the War Office booked me into second, not first class, and I've had a fine time of it too. The crew wouldn't let me in the first cabin at all. It's just today I located you. Look at this. A German colonel named Zeitel. He's inspecting their embassies in Havana, Washington, and Mexico City. We know better. 10 days ago, the Bureau got word that Zeitel has in his possession a priceless copy of the Rubaiyat of Omar Khayyam, stolen 2 months ago in Paris after its purchase by a very highly placed member of His Majesty's government. The Rubaiyat's a book, a collection of medieval Persian poetry, a passion of his lordship's.
That's an actual real book, by the way.
Poetry. Persians. The German High Command must think it's important enough to have their top man smuggle the lot on board. It's your job to find out. His lordship's watching this very closely. Very closely indeed. I wouldn't fumble this chance either, unless you fancy spending the rest of your career in some grotty Midlands back office shuffling paper about. Have you seen the report? In your trunk? On the international situation? I'd jolly well read it if I were you. No. He's with the protégé. Name of Haidelitz, I believe. The two spend a great deal of time in the Café Parisien. Nibbling pastry. Get into the wireless room. I don't know or care how. Officer Morrow wouldn't let me in. See if Zeitel's received or sent any telegrams about the Rubaiyat. You've got a cryptograph in your trunk. It'll unscramble the German codes. You use the brains God gave you. Watch people. Listen, when you find the Rubaiyat, knock on my door. Cabin F, 34. Use the second class stairs. You should be set. Remember, this is your big chance. Don't fail.
Thank you very much. Right, I will save. Okay, I need to fix the sound issue with this game, the known issue. I will be back in a second, so see you in a bit. See you in a moment. Googled a little and fixed a problem. That's better. Let's see. Oh, it's good. All right. So we have a mystery to solve. Of the intercept telegrams. All right.
This section's off limits. Passengers aren't allowed on the bridge. Officer Moro's in no mood to accommodate passengers right now. He's misplaced his binoculars, and he's in a right proper state about it too. Off with you now.
I need to find his binoculars.
Come here.
Good evening. Third Officer Moro here. I am sorry, but this is the officer's promenade. No passengers allowed. Yes, though the only thing to watch is the wireless room. They just keep bringing up more messages. Wireless telegraphy is all the rage these days. Not tonight, I'm afraid. I've got an uneasy feeling. Something seems wrong. Yes, very calm. No moon. I don't like that. Can't see what's coming. No moon means surprises, as if we don't have enough already. Mr. Ismay, the White Star Line's president's on board. We're walking eggshells round him, I tell you. Though that's nothing compared to the creeping about my brother-in-law's doing at the moment. His entire London office is in an uproar. Tom works in the Admiralty. Seems our plans for troop deployments against Germany disappeared 3 weeks ago. Tom says the big boys are petrified the Jerrys will get wind of it. Could upset the balance of power. Politics. Desktop espionage. Bureaucrats. Pah, give me the sea. You can toss the rest. Never have. Not since the war. Then why are so many people thinking about it? Lucky? No, I wouldn't think that I was. South Africa. Boer War. The officer was a drinker. He was drunk when they trapped us out on the veldt. On a moonless night, it was a massacre. We never saw them coming. Drink always leads to the devil. An interesting connection. For all I know, it could be true. A man's got his troubles, sick child, being away from home. But I hate whiners and apologizers. Well, thank you for your insight. Have a look, why don't you? Mind you, Phillips will have my head if he catches you in there, but I don't see any harm. Go on in.
There you go, ultimate. Rich? A lot of eyes. A lot of eyes warning. Yes.
I believe it is not correct form to speak to those who have not been introduced. Good night.
Passenger? I can't regulate the steam for boilers 1 and 2, so I don't have time for you. You're where you shouldn't be. Get up top, before you're kicked up there. Oh, I doubt it. She's really acting up. See? Still working the bugs out of her. See for yourself. Have at it. There's a gauge showing the turbine's power output. The needle's got to move into the green zone. Over here.
Over this one.
Running much smoother now. Say, since you were so interested, go on, have a peek in the engine room. She's quite a sight.
Excuse me, I would speak with you. Forgive me, I am sorry to intrude on you, a person of such high station. I am Vlad. I have many. I am leaving my home. I am a Serb and they have killed my wife, my children, the Austrians. For that, they will pay. But I do not want to burden you. Please, I need a favor. I have a friend in first class, in cabin A-14. Mr. Babacan has a package for me. Can you bring it here? I am a stowaway. If I am caught, maybe they throw me overboard. Please get the package. I've eaten nothing since we sailed, save for a rat who is not so fast. His name is Barbican, in A14. Tell him you've come from Vlad. He will give you the package. I wait here for your return. Your assistance will be repaid manyfold.
Oh no, I need some. Is this Gregory coming? Time is running out.
You're leaving? Wait. I have been looking for this. Thank you.
Thank you.
I say, would you step?
Are you hurt, Henry?
No harm done. No harm.
I'm so sorry.
Trot on my toe.
We're the Goss Joneses from Haltwhistle, you know. How are you finding the crossing? You're English, then. I would have thought American. Oh, my, my. I didn't mean to insult you.
Can't hold a thought.
Dreadfully large place, America.
Brain like as if she's got...
all that space and all those immigrants trying to fill it up. I was just commenting to Henry. On a white star crossing, one meets all the right people. Why, we were just chatting with a delightful elderly couple in the reception. The Strausses, wasn't that right?
Own a small dry goods store in New York somewhere. Called Macy's.
On D-Deck.
Ribena, must you always finish my sentences? You're as jumpy as that American chap, that photographer.
Yes, he was just snapping away.
Taking pictures of some German colonel and that Englishman.
Snap, snap, snap.
War's coming, all right. Mark my words.
War? How beastly. Will Mr. Burns have to fight? He and his wife, such sweet things. But I do see her point. It is their honeymoon. Why he insists on snapping those photos, I haven't a clue.
For God's sake, woman, talk, 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 like a madam in a Rangoon bawdy house.
Henry, that's unspeakable.
So don't speak then. Yap's louder than a scrum of rabid corgis. Now see here, this Burns chap.
If you want to see something interesting, take a look at his pictures. He's on C deck, cabin C, 78.
Thanks for that information.
Yes? You found him. Sasha Barbican of Barbican Galleries. Now, what is it that I can help you with? For Vlad? He's on board? Please come in. He did it. I told him not to, told him I'd pay his ticket, but he was too proud. Such a tragedy about his family. They were with my mother's people. When Austria took Bosnia, they were killed. Many were. With his family dead, America seems as good a place as any for Vlad.
You're in America, then. That's
Ask Vlad, I don't know. Here, his things. He'll be glad to get them. It's rather late. Good night. Enjoy your voyage.
Thank you. I must see Mr. Barbican. I've bad news. He will not be happy. I am looking for something. Something very important, but it's not here. You have seen a small... It is of no importance. Good night.
Look at my master plan unfolding. I have the will by art. I am a genius. Everything I'm also ready to invest in, I guess. Alright.
Did you get it? Did you find the Rubaiyat? Smashing. What have you learned? More art? Zeitel's no connoisseur. No, there's something about that painting of interest to the German High Command. Let me see. That's the Rubaiyat, all right. Well done. Leave it with the purser for safekeeping. It shall be undisturbed there. I don't have any information about Vlad, but the other fellow, look here. Zeitel's Titanic contact is a London art dealer named Sasha Barbican. They say he smuggles art, and he's not above selling stolen merchandise. The files say he's Serbian, interestingly enough, with links to some shady Balkan groups. The painting's what Zeitel's really after. You must secure it. Where or how, I don't care. Just find it and bring it back here. Remember, leave the Rubaiyat with the purser for safekeeping. He might also know where the painting's stored. Sneak a peek at his cargo manifest. That should help you find the painting. Cargo stored somewhere beneath the forecastle deck. Things are thickening up quite nicely, aren't they? We've got to get our hands on that painting. Don't fail.
No pressure at all. Oh, another cutscene. Because there's multiple stuff.
What do you want? Very nice. Security is our first priority. I'll put it in the safe. Why, what do you know? Not that it matters. I'm much too busy. I must get this message through from Mr. Thayer. Mr. Thayer expects his private train car to meet him in New York. And I can't leave my post, but I need to send this telegram. Help? Yes, it might be helpful if you delivered this message to the wireless room for me. Even better, why don't you send it for me? Mr. Thayer is a very important man. So send the telegram at once. And when you have, don't forget to tell me. That's all then, is it? Good night. Only I'm allowed to access the cargo manifest. What do you want? Glad to be of service. Good night.
Good night. So now we go to...
attract Zeitel and Sasha to the ship's stern. They're having a rather heated conversation. See if you can listen in. I'll track their movements.
We have a problem, Zeitel.
Which is?
The ruby on it was not at your drop point.
You are sure?
Most definitely.
But I put it there myself. What happened?
There's a third party on board, an agent working against you. Against us.
How do you know?
My servant saw them at the drop. They now have the ruby on. This could ruin me, Zeitel, if I were found out.
We should take precautions.
What about the painting? Did your associate bring it up from the cargo hold?
No, I don't have it.
No? But I put it there myself.
Sasha, I've discovered a traitor. Don't look so startled. It is not you.
You mean Hadelitz, your associate?
No longer my associate, I am afraid. Willy was an intellectual. And intellectuals aren't smart enough for espionage. Now, I must recover the painting and its plans. I fear this third party may already have possession of it.
And Hadelitz?
Thank you for asking. Billy will bring no further harm to the Fatherland, I assure you. Let us plan.
Passengers aren't allowed on the bridge. Officer Morrow's in no mood to accommodate.
Which? Yeah, this is one of the more boring. Puzzle! Wait. Was it? Oh, we can. This is why mobile phones are cheap. Yeah, it's fine.
Yes, can I help you? You sent it? Marvelous. I was afraid you'd forgotten. Mr. Thayer will be most grateful. And let them think the purser's not doing his job. I am the purser, and as purser, I am the one who looks after the passengers. Mr. Thayer is vice president of the Pennsylvania Railroad, and it is I who shall inform the Thayers that their train will be waiting. So, if you'll excuse me.
honest.